Hello students, welcome back to Commercial Arithmetic class. So in previous video we had solved 7 problems on simple interest. So in today's class we will see some more problems. So we'll start with the 8th problem. The question is, at what rate of simple interest a sum is also known as principal. So at what rate of simple interest a sum of money doubles itself in 8 years. So I hope you remember the note that we had studied in our second class. So there I had mentioned, I think it was in the end of the last 5 to 10 minutes, there I had mentioned in note, if the amount doubles itself in simple interest, then n into r will be 100. If it triples itself, then it will be 200 and so on. So we will use that note to solve this problem. So in this question they have given n, which is n or t, which is 8 years, and they have asked to find out rate, which is r. So now we will use that note. So when the sum doubles itself, then we know n into r is 100. So we will substitute what is n, which is 8 into r equal to 100. So you want to find out r, then that will be 100 divided by 8, which is 12.5% per annum. So just see, using that note we will get the answer in just 2 steps. So please remember that note. If this question is asked for 2 marks, then you can solve exactly this way. But if the same question is asked for 5 marks, I'll explain how to solve. So what is given? They have given n is equal to 8 years and we have to find out rate. But they have given the statement, a sum of money doubles itself. So if you are taking that sum to be 100 rupees, then the double of that will be obviously 200. The triple of that will be 300. If you want, you can take even 1 rupee as the sum. So double of that will be 2 rupees. But it is always better to express in terms of 100. So now I have assumed the sum to be 100 rupees, then the amount will be 200 rupees. So by using this formula, we can find out the unknown quantity, which is r over here. So the formula is a is equal to p into 1 plus nr by 100. So a is 200, p is 100. So 1 plus, in place of n we will substitute 8. So we will solve for r. So this 100 is multiplied over here. So when it goes to left hand side, it will go to the denominator. So it is 200 by 100, which is equal to 1 plus 8r by 100. So when you simplify this 2 zeros will get cancelled. So 2 by 1 is 2. And here 1 is there on the right hand side. If it goes to the left hand side, then it will become subtraction, because here it is and it has addition symbol. So it is 2 minus 1 equal to 8 by 100. So it is 1. So this 100 goes to the left hand side. So it will be 1 into 100 is 100, which is equal to 8r. We want r, therefore r will be 100 divided by 8, which is 12.5% per annum. You can see we got the same answer, but here we have assumed nr equal to 100. Not assumed, it is a note actually. So you can see we have got that step over here. This is your n, this is your r, which is 100, but by using the note we have directly written. So if asked for 5 marks, you can solve by using this method. So for the same question, if r was given as 12.5 and if n was asked, then everything remains the same, only here the unknown things get a different answers, and here in place of r you will be having n as 8. You can try to solve that. So I hope this problem is clear. So if asked for 2 marks, you can go for this, but if you're trying to solve by this, then you have to clearly write the statement, When the sum doubles itself by simple interest, then we know that nr equal to 100, and then substitute what is given and then solve for the unknown. So let us see the ninth problem. A sum of money triples itself at 10% per annum simple interest. Find the period. So here they have given a amount or the principal triples itself at what rate? At 10%, and you have to find out n. So they have given r, you have to find n. So since the sum triples by simple interest, then we have nr is equal to 200. So in place of r, substitute 10, which is given. So n will be 200 by 10, which is 20 years. So if you want to solve for 5 marks the same question, so take p as 100, then amount will be 300, that is 3 times of the sum. Then you can use a is equal to p into 1 plus nr by 100. So you will get the same answer, n is equal to 200. If not, you can use, what you can do is, I will just explain here. We know a is equal to p plus I, where I is the simple interest. A is 300. What is p? Initially it will be 100 plus I. We don't know what is simple interest. So you can find out I, which will be 300 minus 100, which is 200 is your simple interest. So in this, now you can substitute nr pnr by 100. So what is your I? It is 200. So I'll take this to this side. It will be 200, so double 0. And your p is again 100. And what is your r in that question? R is 10. So into 10 is again 0, n. So 3 zeros, 3 zeros. So you can see your n is again 20 years. So even you can use this formula. So anything works, but your method should be elaborate and you have to write the steps clearly. So either you can use this formula, or using amount and principal you can find out interest, simple interest, and then you can use the formula of simple interest, that is PNR by 100, and then you can find out the unknown term. They will be given R and the principal, they will ask to find out N, or else they will give N and R and they will ask to find out principal. Anything, but if you know these two formulas, you can solve by any convenient method. So let us see the 10th problem. At what rate of simple interest a sum of money triples itself in 12.5 years? So here they have asked to find out R in 12.5 years, given the sum triples itself. So we know when the sum triples, nr is 200. So here n is 12.5 is nothing but 12.5. so r will be 200 divided by 12.5, which is 16% per annum is the rate. Try by using the other method. So the 11th problem is, in what period will rupees 9000 amount to rupees 11,700 at 20% per annum simple interest? So here in this, 9000 is your principal amount and 11,700 is your amount, and r is 20%. You have to find out n. So we know amount is equal to principal plus the simple interest. So here we can find out interest. So it will be amount minus principal, which turns out to be 2700. Just like I explained the previous problem, this is very similar to that. But instead of giving amount triples or doubles, they have given the amount directly. So initially it was 9000, then it turns out to be 11700. So you can use the formula, you can use this formula and simplify, or else you can solve by this method. The choice is yours. So here I have solved by this method. First I have found simple interest. Then once I get the simple interest, in the formula all the quantities are known except the period, that is n. So we will substitute whatever is given and we'll find out the unknown. So with this we got simple interest 2700. Now the formula for simple interest is PNR by 100. So simple interest is 2700. I'll substitute that. And your P is 9000, N is unknown, R is 20% divided by 100. Therefore, this goes to the left hand side, it will be multiplication. So 2007 into 100 is equal to 9000 into 20, and the zeros will get cancelled. So you'll be remaining with 27 by 18, which turns out to be 1.5. years. So the last, the 12th question is, find the rate of simple interest if rupees 2200 amount to rupees 3190 in 2.5 years. So in this problem I have solved using directly this formula. You can try by using this method to find out the rate. You will get the same answer. So let us see how to simplify by using the formula of amount. So here they have given principal amount to be 2200 and amount to be 3190 and n is 2.5. you have to find out the rate. So let us substitute all the terms in this formula. So now you have to solve for this r. So first this 2200 goes to the left hand side, it will go to the denominator. So 3190 by 2200 is 1.45. so this one comes to the left hand side, it will become minus 1. So 1.45 minus 1, and 2.5 by 100 is 0.025 r. So if not, you can keep as it is and it will go to multiplication and this will come to division, you will get the same answer. So it is 1.5 minus 1 is equal to 0.025 r. so you want r, so 0.45 divided by 0.025 gives you the required answer, which is 18% per annum as the rate of simple interest. You try by this method using the formula of simple interest, you will get the same answer. So the last problem for today is, in what time will rupees 820 amount to rupees 841.87 at 4% per annum simple interest. So here the principal amount is 820, amount is 841.87 and the rate is 4%. You have to find the period, which is n. I have done, the steps are same everything till finding n, but here you can see we got n as 0.6675, so 0.6675 years, or else you can keep it in months, which will be, to get into months you have to multiply by 12, therefore it will be approximately 8 months. If not, in the formula here you can divide it by 12, you will directly get over here. If you are not multiplying by n and you get the answer in decimals, which is less than 0, then you can multiply by 12 and express the same in terms of months, which will be 8 months. If you divide 8 by 12, then this will be 0.667 years. Again you'll get back to this answer. So it is better to write in months or in terms of years. So these were the simple problems. In the next class we will solve general problems of simple interest. So please try to solve all these problems and mention the steps clearly.